This is an animated explanation of a really, really, and I mean really cool effect. When you dip in an LED in a liquid nitrogen and cool it down, it changes the color of the LED. So, if your country has traffic lights made of LED, get out of your car and pour some liquid nitrogen on it. It might change its color and you might land in prison. This was shown in Action Slab latest video. No, not the traffic light part. Go check it out if you haven't already. You take a red LED, put it in liquid nitrogen, and its color changes to yellow or orange. So we have red light going to yellow, and then we had yellow LED turning into orange, and then green turns into blue, and blue LED is going more violet. I think you see the pattern. If you look at the visible color spectrum, you'll notice that it goes from violet to red. The shorter wavelength of light is toward the violet and so high energy. The longer wavelength of light is toward the red, so lower energy. It would seem that when we are sticking these LEDs in the liquid nitrogen, it's shifting the wavelength of light coming off of it to have shorter wavelength and higher energy. To understand this, I'll just do a brief overview of how LEDs work. I promise it won't be long and detailed. LEDs are semiconductors, stuffed together. A useful way to visualize the mechanism in semiconductors is to plot out their energies for electrons within the material. Rather than having distinct energies as with the case of free atoms, the energy states which are available form bands. The conduction band is a band of electron orbitals that electrons can bounce up into from the valence band when energized. At the point when electrons are in these orbitals, they have enough energy to move freely in the material. This movement of electrons make electrical inflow. Valence band is energy band formed by a series of energy levels containing valence electrons. Now what happens is that an electron falls down to a lower energy state, and when that happens, sometimes they can produce a photon of light. Now wider the band gap, the more energy will be released when the electron falls from the valence band to the conduction band. You change the band gap and it will change how much energy the electron will release when it falls from a high energy state to a low energy state, and so changes the color. So as the temperature of LEDs increase, it makes the atom inside the semiconductor go mad and they all start to vibrate. And when those atoms vibrate more, it will increase the interatomic distance and so increases the lattice constant. The valence electrons sort of get more free and less energy is required to make them go into the conduction band. In terms of our band theory, the band gap decreases. And when the band gap decreases, it means the electrons don't have to fall as far. And so that increases the wavelength of light released. Okay, enough mumbo jumbo. So, what does it all mean? You dip an LED in liquid nitrogen, you decrease the temperature which increases the band gap, and when those electrons fall to the other side, they will emit a higher energy photon with shorter wave. This is what happens when you put a green LED into liquid nitrogen. You increase the band gap, and when those electrons decide to fall off, they emit blue light with more energy. Thanks for watching, and if you are new here, consider subscribing, because you know, I would want you to watch my future videos which are equally as shit as this one.